Hello, beautiful people. Hello, wonderful people. Hello, my people. My people, my people, my people, my friends. My friends, my fans, my mommies, my daddies. I say, welcome back to my channel. My name is Mesa, the queen of positivity. Assurance covers so that this recipe is going to work for you. And it will come back to thank God Almighty for you have done this, for giving you this secret. I want to talk about the use of this hygiene to break some curse out of your life. How do you use this dry gin to break curse out of your life? Now, when you get this, your dry gin, the woman gets 21 seeds of alligator pepper, 21 seeds of alligator pepper, and put inside this dry gin. Put the 21 seed of alligator pepper inside this dry gin. Now, some people will just come out and pack a sand. They will make a declaration that it will never be well with you. It will never prosper. This and this, if you well with it, like after they are saying it, you know that the earth has mouth. That is why even if you are great, you are big, you are president, the earth will still swallow. You will still go down to 6 feet. So you have to respect yourself. No matter how big you are, the same earth, they will still commit you to Mother Earth's name. So Mother Earth is always ready to take as many as can consume. So when they pronounce that curse against the Mother Earth, will take that curse. They will return the sun back. And the Mother Earth will hold that curse against you. As long as you are stepping on the ground, you can't suspend in the air for eternity. You will still sit down, it's on the ground. You are walking, it's on the ground. You are lying down, you're on the ground. You are driving, you're on the ground. As long as you sit on the ground will always block. The door of favor will be blocked, will lock. The Mother Earth will lock that door against you. Because somebody has come to report you to her. Now, another time, some people can take their hand, they are fixed, and they will be hitting the ground and be laying curse on you. When they hit us, they will just be hitting their feet in the ground. They will just be laying that curse. As they do that, your mother, your father, they do that because you provoke them. The mother ends with her jackets. All right, and say, okay, oh. And whenever you go, if you are in abroad, you see yourself in fire. Your father's house, because something was done in your father's house. A curse was laid. So people will hit the wall. They will hit the wall. Hit the wall. If you succeed, they will put their hand, they will lift it up and show it to Chukotuke. They will now hit the wall. Hit the wall. The Mother Earth will attack you because the same sand is used to make the beauty. The same beauty stays on the sand. Okay, the Mother Earth will hijack it and hold it against you. Anywhere you are going, the course is following. Door of favor, the Mother Earth will lock that door. You see that the ground is not favoring you. You plant fruit, when you harvest it, devourer will come and devour them. Because Mother Earth has been committed to work against you. So how do you break no and unknown curse made on the Mother Earth? All right, when you put your alligator pepper inside this jersey bottle, okay, you're going to wake up early in the morning, early enough. All right, when you wake up, you come out in the morning dew. Those of you that you, wherever you are, some people will say they can't do that. If you do it on ties cannot drink it. I don't know about that. I've never done it on ties. But it is before you go to the beach where there is sand. I want where you see sand. That's where you want to do the prayer. All right. When you get there, go to, for example, the beach or your compound. Early in the morning, if you can do that in your compound, good. Maybe it's your building. You come out, there's a space where there is sand, your garden, your yard, your garden where you plant those things, they are your compound. just where you can have sand. When you go there, you stand on that sand, barefooted, no stockings, no shoe, no slippers. Your two legs on the ground. You stand there, you begin to make your prayer. You talk to Mother Earth. I've come to Mother Earth. I've come to you. I call God Almighty, His Son, and the Holy Spirit, my guardian angels, to bear witness that I don't know what is wrong with me. I don't even know who has cursed me. I don't know if I've cursed myself unknowingly, that any curse they have cursed me or have cursed myself, that today I've come to renounce that curse. I've come to break that curse. I've come to tell you that Mother Earth, that I am your children, that a mother blesses the child, that I need a blessing. Now, let me tell you, you were made with sand. With the sand, they will still bury you. So, there's no way to ask me too much questions. Okay? The sand, they don't call it sand. They call it Mother Earth. Correct. You know, we have elements. We have earth. We have sun. We have fire. We have water. We have air. That space. That you've come today. That any cause made against me, mercy, chinery, oh boy, queen of positivity today, that you are using this dry gin to break that cause. Any fire, because cause is like a fire, any fire or smoke coming out from the ground as a result of that cause that they've made lay that have cost me or have cost myself, following me where I go, because the smoke and the fire of the cause follows you wherever you go. You say you have been cursed, so don't favor, she has been cursed, she has been cursed, she has been cursed, she has been cursed. In one way or the other, maybe you've been cursed, you will not marry. Maybe you've been cursed, you will not have a child. Maybe you've been cursed, you will not make it. So even when you are trying to make it, that smoke will come. You've been cursed. No way. Those demons will say no way. Alright. By the time you begin to pour this on the ground, that fire, that anger, that smoke will be ritualized and it will vanish. You pour it, you are making your prayer. You cancel that curse made upon you, made upon your husband, or you are the one that cursed somebody. You cursed your son as a woman. You cursed your husband. You cursed yourself using this sand. The way I've explained it like that. You see, every curse I've cursed my husband or wherever my children, I am renouncing that curse. Or you don't know who cursed you, you renounce that curse. Because some people, when they say curse breakers, so bath, they still bath, the thing did not go. You ask yourself, what's the problem? You begin to pour it. You pour it 7 times. You make prayer, you drop. You make a prayer, you drop like 7 drops on the floor. Now you begin, after you have done making that prayer, okay? Please, turn your back on that particular spot where you have poured, where you have break that curse, where you have poured the 7 drop of this dry gin that have 21 seeds of alligator pepper in it. I turn my back on that curse from now henceforth. It is written, Numbers 23:23. No enchantment against me, mercy, and no any divination against me. From now on, I am free from curse. Alright? Then turn your back on that position. Go to another position. Face your front. You begin to bless yourself. From now on, the ground will bless me. The universe will bless me. The creator of the universe will bless me. Anywhere I step on the ground will bless me. For it is written, wherever the soul of your feet shall trample upon, they I will give unto you for a possession, for an inheritance, and this is the word of the Lord for me. Therefore, in this Lagos, I will prosper. Home and abroad, I will prosper. Lying down, sleeping, as long as I step on this ground, the ground will bless me. Whatever I planted will yield fruit. I will walk like an ant, and I will eat like an elephant. I will have bountiful harvest, and I will bless God I created. Do you understand? You begin to bless yourself. You are blessing, you are pouring this drink on your front. You bless yourself. You put your two legs together, you drop the drink. You bless yourself. As I stand on this ground, you bless yourself. You drop the drink, you bless yourself. You drop the drink on your hands, you bless your hands. When you are done blessing yourself, please, you go back home. Alright, from there, you just turn home, enter your vehicle, you drive, you go back home, or you enter inside your compound. Now, if you are living in a house where people are much, please leave that place, go to an empty space, empty land, empty space, go to the beach. Nobody will stop you for praying in the beach. There is sand there, so don't come and ask me if my compound people are there and come. Please go to where there is space. Bush, anywhere, there is space for you to make prayer as quiet as early in the morning. All right? Some people will say because of work, they will not have time. They will not be able to leave the house early in the morning. Early in the morning, morning is one that is comfortable for you before speaking to anyone. But if you cannot do it early in the morning, please know in the evening. You can do it. You can do it in the evening. Alright? Whichever one. But I would have preferred early in the morning. When there is still morning dew dropping. Okay? You can see it. Maybe your house is far from the beach. You can go and lodge in a hotel closer to the beach. In the morning, you come out from that hotel. You make that prayer. You go to the beach. Go where there is sand. You make the prayer. Okay? You make the prayer. Like me, my house is upstairs. I can come down the front of my gates. There is sand. Early in the morning, I will stand and make my prayer. Make my prayer. Anybody passing you on your own, you greet me at once. I'm praying. Sometimes when people want to greet me, I start coughing. I'm coughing so that I will not talk to you. I will make my prayer. Then I'm going back inside my house. Open the gate. I enter back. I go back. Some people say, when I have assignment to you, if you greet me, I will not answer. When I finish, I greet you because greeting is not love. There is time for anything. Some people, they will, Satan will send them. That time, she's going, oh yeah, this Satan. Sometimes I will rebuke every spirit. I will bind them first. Sometimes I say, Holy Spirit, let your mercy go with me. Let this assignment be successful. That's the best way. Always telling ahead. Maybe you are doing it in 3 days' time. Now you start asking mercy of God. Let this assignment be successful. You will see that day. You will do it successfully. Some people just wake up. I don't wake up and tell assignment. But no. Some days I will be calling. You know, be talking to God about it. He's away already, but I will bring it to his notice. Your daughter is wants to do this thing. Please, I want it peacefully. This is because I know that there are some forces that monitor that will not want you to do it. So I've tried to answer your question, because some of your question, when I see the question, I want to fix. All right, now another benefit of it is that you can do it for somebody that is not around. You only break that curse. When you turn your back, you always bless that person using the earth. My husband and abroad, I bless you. I will tell you how you can wake up and begin to bless that your son, your husband, that is far from you using this. That one, you can do it in your house anyway, you can be doing it. Uh-huh. Then I'll give you the scriptures about it. So after you have done this, how many days will I do this? Just one day. You come back. Please, you alligator pepper, 7 in your mouth, chewing as you are breaking the curse. Once you chew as you are breaking the curse, after you breaking the curse, break the curse, finish praying, spit it out. Don't swallow. If you swallow the spit, no one will still spit the remaining alligator pepper out. Turn back, use the same mouth that is still paining you and bless yourself. Mm-hmm. All right, so some of you, this Holy Spirit will direct you how you do it more. Mm-hmm. So this is how you can use this to break some certain code. Now, the remaining 21 seed of alligator pepper inside this jar, leave it too. We are still coming to use this for something. So still leave it. Don't ask, what do I do with the remaining one? Don't ask if you want to drink it on your own. Shall leave it. I'll still tell you what you do with it. Hmm.